Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Austin here, back with another Brawl Stars video. Today, if you are not aware and have been living under a rock, today the Brawl Talk came out, so I'm going to go over some information that came out with Brawl Talk, talking about some Brawl boxes, some skins that we got, nerfs that we'll see, and some buffs. And then at the end of the video, we'll go over some hypercharges and the new two brawlers. Let's get right into it. So on the screen, you're going to see some pictures and some gameplay from the video. So I'll link that down in the description. And while you're down there, go ahead and like and subscribe and comment how your weekend is and how it's going. So without further ado, let's get into it. So first, Brawl Boxes are back. If you're not aware, Brawl Boxes are kind of like chests in Clash Royale, if you ever played that. But if you haven't played that either, it's more of just an abundance of rewards at once instead of star drops being only one reward. So in Brawl Boxes, you are able to get bling, coins, brawler points slash power points, however you want to say it, gems, coins, skins, XP tokens, brawlers, and more. This is really good for the game. Apparently, you're going to have to play daily. You get a certain amount and then I think it's like 10 or so, and then you'll be able to unlock a Brawl Box. So 10 star drops, in a sense, unlock one big Brawl Box. I'm not sure if they're taking out star drops entirely or what they're doing, but yes. So this will run July 12th through July 31st, and I hope it's going to be good. Brawl Boxes were really nice, and they're coming out with different game modes for throwbacks, such as, I forget what they called it, but it's the normal brawlers that started the game, no gadgets, no gears, and you just play with the, I think, 42 brawlers, it said. So that'll be super fun. Another addition that they're adding is it's easier to play again with the people that you are playing with. So if you get into a game and you are liking the team that you have and you hit that play again button, you can go back to the menu and your team will still be there just in case you finish a quest or you want to change your brawler or something like that. This is also great because you get double XP tokens when playing in a team. So they are trying to push people and advise people to start playing in teams. So that's really nice. Next up, we have new Brawl Pass skin, which is going to be Medusa EMZ. As you can see on screen, there's going to be three different ones. So those will be super cool. The season that they're saying it's going to be Gods versus Monsters season. So I'm really hyped for it. It looks really good. There's a lot more skins that are coming out, including a Rico Hypercharge skin, and I'm really, really excited to see how that one plays. But if you want to see the rest of the skins, I don't want to bore you guys, so go ahead and go over to the link in the description, watch that video about all the skins. But let's get into the brawlers, actual brawler talk. So first, we see in the video that Angelo is getting a damage nerf. As you can see, his arrow did 400 damage and it usually does 440. So we could see a 40 decrease in that. So that'll, in the next clip here, you see Hank is getting a buff in health. As you can see, he increases his health and he has more health than he's supposed to right now. So they're doing that. And then there was some speculation about a Meg rework. As you can see here, it looks like she's shooting more, but I don't know. We'll kind of have to see how that goes. Next up, Frank looks like he hits faster, potentially maybe lower the health, higher the attack speed kind of thing, but you guys be the judge of that. I put that on screen for you guys, so let me know how you feel about that. Next up, we have the hyperchargers. Hyperchargers, as you can see, I'm gonna go in order, so it's gonna be Barley first. It looks like it's gonna be super strong. The biggest hindrance for Barley is people hiding in a bush and coming out, so the fact that you can break the bush and kind of make it so the map's more open for Barley could really help him out and make him a top like 25 brawler in the game. So hopefully that's good. Next up, we have Frank. He affects a 360 degree radius and he stuns all his opponents. And as you can see, it looks like he's attacking a little bit faster here, but I'm not 100% sure, like I said. But regardless, he affects a 360 degree radius and he stuns his opponent, being able to kill all opponents around him. Next, we have Angelo. He is getting a hypercharge, as I mentioned in a video prior. The super follows him wherever he goes. This is gonna be super, super overpowered, so get ready for more Angelo. The damage, I don't think, is really gonna matter too much, especially with this addition of the hypercharge. Next up, we have Piper. Piper now drops 6 bombs and knocks back all the opponents when she lands. So that'll be super viable for her. She knocks back people when she lands, and the bombs knock back people, as you already know. So Piper could be another S tier brawler, but I'm going to keep her an A until I see how this works. Next up, we have EMZ. EMZ knocks back and shoots smoke in 360 degree radius at first, and then the radius is a little bit bigger for the brawlers. Rico is next up. Projectiles shoot further. It kind of seems like they're taking a book out of the mutations and making them as a hypercharge, which I'm super excited about. Rico is one of the best brawlers in the mutation, so we're going to see how that goes. Hopefully it's not as overpowered, but we will see. And the addition of the hypercharge skin, so hopefully that'll be super fun. And finally on the list, we have Gale, which I am super happy about. I feel like Gale has been underrated, and I love using Gale, especially in ranked. So the super is wider and shoots twice. It could potentially stun if you have the star power. So if you kind of mend those two together, it'll be super, super solid and super good, I think. It might be honestly A tier now, around A tier for Gale. So I'm hoping, yeah, those are the hyperchargers. Again, I will list them off. We have Barley, Frank, Angelo, Piper, EMZ, Rico, and Gale. Super excited about all these. Mostly excited about EMZ, Rico, and Gale, but we'll see how the rest of them play out. Next up on the list, we have the new brawlers. One of them is Barry, which is an epic brawler. Allows to get super from healing. He can gain his super from healing his opponents or healing himself. His super heals while going through them. So if he supers somebody, as you can see on the screen, it's kind of like a Fang super. He dashes towards somebody, but it heals his teammates through. He heals his teammates through, and he drops the paint. As you can see, the trail of paint that he leaves heals, and he does 1300 damage, 1320 to be exact. Heals 660, but the super does 3040, and his health is around 5400. And I think he will be a fun brawler and a nice one to max out in the next season. Honestly, probably the better one out of the two, in my opinion. I'd have to see how the next one plays out. But the next one we're gonna have is Clancy. He is a mythic brawler. It's kind of like Surge. He has three stages. His health is at 6,600, 1,600 damage, 2,400 damage for stage one of his super with the spray. And then super changes each level. In stage two, his shots fire quicker. And we're just gonna have to kind of see how that all plays into a part. But I'm super excited for the season. Let me know if you guys are super excited.